God, we thank you for this opportunity we have, Father, to witness the joining of this couple. God, we thank you for your Son who makes this possible. And Father, we just ask that this ceremony, this marriage would be God-honoring, would make much of your Son, Jesus. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. Marriage is a covenant, not a contract. Contracts have escape clauses. They have loopholes and ways out of them. But a spiritual covenant that they're about to make is meant to be eternal. It's meant to be forever. In 1 Corinthians, it says this. It says, love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Dylan and Brianna, I want to charge you both to always remember that just as the foundation of the church is Christ, so the foundation of your marriage from this point forward is Christ. He is what will sustain your marriage. He is what will support your marriage and strengthen your marriage for all of your life. You keep him at the center of your marriage and you won't mess up. I, Dylan, receive you, Brianna, to be my wife. I accept you as a precious gift from God. I promise to love you and lead you as a spiritual leader of this home. I promise to be by your side through the good and the bad, and to be your rock in sickness and in health as long as we both shall live. And now, having made a commitment of your love and loyalty to each other, and having sealed your commitment to one another by exchanging a symbol of your love, I do, by the authority vested in me as a minister of Jesus Christ, pronounce you husband and wife. Dylan, you've been patient. You can kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it's with great privilege and honor I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Dylan Grombach.
Remember to confused.